I praise our Almighty Heavenly Father for this wonderful time. I thank God for this beautiful moment, and I welcome each and every one of you in this beautiful moment, the time that where we can meditate upon the Word of God, where we can listen to the Word of God. That very soon, the time is coming that there will be a famine for the Word of God, and at that time, many beautiful young girls and handsome young boys will be running up and down for the Word of God, but they'll not listen, but they'll not get the Word of God. For during that time, the Word of God will be stopped. But friends, let me tell you, today you are so lucky, we are so lucky that we have got the privilege to listen to the Word of God. So as these few days we're studying all about the repentance, the why we need to repent. And we have studied already the 3 points about why do we need to repent. And today we are going to study a 4th point, and that is about repentance free us from the torment of sin. Repentance free us from the torment of sin. Many of us, we does not want to be under something else, under the control of someone. As long year back, with the Indian, we were under the bondage of British, and British were ruling us. And there were many Indian people, they fight. They sacrifice their life so that we'll get freedom. And because of their sacrifice, we have got the freedom from those British rule. And every one of us living in this world today, we does not want ourselves to be under someone's control. And so, likewise, today, God does not want us to be under the control of sin. God does not want us to be under the control of sin, because we are the children of God. We are the world, we are the children of God. We are the precious son and daughter of God. We are very precious jewel in the sight of God. God loves us abundantly. He came to this world. He sacrificed for you and me so that we'll get freedom from the sin. Christ has sacrificed for your freedom. Christ has sacrificed. Friends, today, are you under the control of sin, or are you free from the sin? Let us see what does the Bible says. Today, if we see in Hebrews chapter 4 verse 16, here it says, "Let us therefore come boldly unto the throne of grace, that we may obtain mercy and find grace to help in time of need." Well, children of God, or fellow believers, today we need to come boldly unto Christ, which means if we will not come boldly unto Christ, that means we will not receive the grace and will not obtain mercy and will not get the mercy from God. And therefore today, if we are under the control of sin, we have to live away. We have to leave behind all the sins, and we have to come to our Lord Savior Jesus Christ through prayer and through our supplication and through the living experience of our life according to the way how Christ wants us to live. Then we'll be free from the sin. And here it says in Hebrews chapter 7 verse 25, here also it says that, "Wherefore he is able to save them to the uttermost that come unto God by him, seeing he ever lived to make intercession for them." That those who live the sinful desire of this world, those who live all this worldly pleasure, those who live all these worldly things which is not acceptable in the sight of God, and those who are coming to God, God is willing to save them, and God can save them because God is a living God. Because our God is God who is the beginning and the end, who is still surviving, who is a living God, is a powerful, is Almighty God. He is willing to save you. Today, my brother and my sister, are you willing to come to that God? Are you willing to leave behind all the sinful desire? Are you willing to leave all those worldly useless desire? And are you willing to come to Christ today? "I want to come myself to Christ so that I'll obtain mercy and grace and I'll be saved by the hand of Christ." 2 Peter chapter 2 verse 19 says that those who are overcome by the sin are the slave of a sin. Here it says, 2 Peter chapter 2 verse 19, "While they promise them liberty, they themselves are the servant of the corruption. For of whom a man is overcome of the same, is he brought in bondage." In other translation, it says that those who are overcome by sin is a slave of the sin. Today, what is sin? Sin is a transgression, transgressing the law of God, which means disobeying God is sin. Today, what all can we call it as a sin? We can call it as stealing, telling a lie, deceiving others, hurting others, and as well as drinking alcohol and fighting, quarreling, and what else? Doing all those bad things, doing all those naughty things, doing all those nasty things which is unacceptable in the sight of God, all these are sin. And when we sin, we become the slave of sin, and our master become the sin, and the sin become our master, and our master, the sin, will not give us eternal life, but sin will destroy our life, and sin will destroy our life. Sin will not allow us to enter into the heavenly eternal kingdom. Today, friends, let us come out from the sin, and to come out from the sin, we need to repent, and we need to give our heart to Jesus Christ. Today, are you willing to come out from the sin? Do you want to be slave under someone else? Let us ask this question to ourselves. Do not become the slave of sin, but become the slave and the servant of Lord Savior Jesus Christ. Our God will use you in a right way. Our God will care for you even though you are a slave or servant. But our God calls us as his friend. How loving our God is. How loving, caring our master is. Let us come to that master. John chapter 8 verse 34, here it says that the one who sin is a slave of sin. Here it says, John chapter 8 verse 34, here it says that Jesus answered them. Friends, no one said, not the Bible writer, not the pastor, not the evangelist, not the prophet, but Jesus Christ the Savior, who created the heaven and the earth, who came to this world and who sacrificed his life for you and me on the cross of Calvary, and who ascended to heaven, and who is preparing a place for you and me in the heavenly kingdom, who is coming back to this world. He said this word that, he said, Jesus answered them, verily, verily, I say unto you, whoever commits sin is servant of sin. Oh, friends, today, are you the servant of sin or are you the servant of God? When we sin, whether small sin or big sin, it is a sin. And when we sin, we become the slave of the sin. And we become the servant of the sin. And when we become the servant of the sin, what will be the reward for committing sin? What will the reward? What sin will give us as a reward? Sin will destroy us. But if we become the servant of God, our Almighty Heavenly God, Heavenly Father, He will give us the eternal salvation. His reward is that He will give us the eternal life. So friends, may God bless us all, and I hope and pray that you'll be blessed with the message, and I hope and pray that let us try to come out from the sin. Let us try to repent from our sin so that we'll be free from sin, so that we'll not be under the sin, but we'll be free from the sin. Let us try to overcome the sin. We can able to overcome the sin when we come to Jesus Christ our Savior. He will help us how to overcome the sin, and He will help us to how to win over the sin. And when we win the sin, we become the friend of Christ. Not the servant of Christ, not the slave of Christ, but we become the friend of Christ. Because Bible itself says that those who do the will of my Father are my friends. He that do according to what the word of God says is my friends. Today God wants to call you as a friend. Today God wants to call you as a friend. I want to come to that Jesus Christ and believe with him heavenly kingdom forever and ever. I want to overcome the sin, and I want to become the friend of Christ. Because if I become the slave of sin, sin will destroy me. Sin will not let me enter into the heavenly kingdom. Sin will not give me eternal life, but it will give me the death. It will give me the death. It will give me the destruction. It will destroy my life. But my Almighty Heavenly Father, my God, if I work for Him, if I become a servant for Him, He will make me as a friend. He will make me as precious son and daughter. He will make everyone of us as His precious son and daughter. Let us come to that God, and He will bless us abundantly. May God bless us all abundantly. Amen.